Hi, everybody. It's Ricky Heller from rickyheller.com. I help people with dietary restrictions learn to love their food again so their bodies can heal and they can focus on living their best lives. Today, I wanted to talk about something that there were so many of these issues that I decided to do a series on this, and that is myths around the anti-candida diet. And so the question that I hear probably the most commonly or definitely one of the very top frequent questions or issues that people come to me with when I work with private clients or in my groups is, I'm losing too much weight. And people are scared that they're just going to keep losing and losing weight on this diet. So I'm here to tell you that that does not have to be the case. In my case, some of you know my story, but when I was first diagnosed with candida, I was basically clinically obese, and I had been on a sugar rampage for decades, and then I lost a lot of weight, about 45 pounds in the first year of following the program, which for me was a welcome loss because, of course, I was overweight to begin with, but not everybody starts that way. So it doesn't necessarily have to work out that you lose a ton of weight, but for a lot of people who start overweight, they may end up losing a ton of weight. And if you are losing weight, so I wanted to look at what might be some of the causes so that you can do something about this. So the first thing to keep in mind is that for most people who are starting an anti-candida program, they are coming off of what we call the SAD diet or the standard American diet. And you don't have to be living in America for it to apply to you. It's basically the Western diet. And so the idea there is that you're eating a lot of processed food. You know, a lot of these foods are really high in added sugars, in processed unhealthy fats, refined flours, all the things that are going to make you gain weight. And if you found a way to eat that way and not gain weight, good for you. But those ingredients are still going to be taken away when you start an anti-candida protocol. And so for a lot of people, that shift from the standard American diet to one that's whole foods, all natural, because of that, they're immediately losing a whole bunch of calories in their diet, and they're not necessarily replacing them efficiently. And so they're going to see their weight plummet when they make that initial shift. The other thing is, for a lot of people who come to this diet, even if you have been a cook before, like I was, there are so many new ingredients and so many restrictions that a lot of people don't really know how to cook this way in a way that they love their food and they're going to keep eating enough to maintain their weight. And so for me, I mean, I was lucky. I came to this from a background in cooking, and I love to cook and I love to experiment. But even in my case, I had some trouble initially coming up with stuff. So what happens is that people will hang on some like really basic dishes and or just eat the actual foods in and of themselves. So if you know that you're allowed to have chicken, for instance, organic chicken, you might have steamed chicken breast every night or roasted chicken breast every night. Or if you know you're allowed to eat broccoli or celery or whatever the vegetables are, you'll just have some plain steamed vegetables with it. And people tend to go on repeat because that's all they can think of, because they can't figure out how to cook yummy, appetizing foods with the anti-candida ingredients. And that's actually one of the main reasons why I created the Candida Kickstart program, was to help people who are struggling with that way of eating and they don't know how to now transfer their skills to the new list of ingredients so that they could still have delicious foods that they liked, that they could serve to their families, and that they wouldn't be tempted to eat less than they really should. Because when you do that, not only are you going to get bored of eating the same food over and over, but you may not be meeting all of your nutritional needs effectively. And so that's the third thing that I would say can sometimes cause weight loss, is people are consuming foods that they know might be candida safe, but overall their meals are not nutritionally sound. And like, that's one of the things, one of the first things I work with my one-on-one clients, is we look at your diet. So if you're losing weight and you don't know why, what you want to do is look at what are the nutrients you're actually getting every day. Are you getting enough carbs? And yes, you're supposed to eat carbs on an anti-candida diet, but healthy carbs and whole foods carbs. Are you getting enough healthy fats? Are you getting enough protein? And if that's all taken care of and you're still losing weight, then there are certain tips and tricks that we can use with your diet, within the foods in the diet, to ensure that you're not losing too much. So it really can be done. You know, and I think in my case, as many of you know, the weight eventually started to rise back up. And I think this also happens for most people, where your body's going to reach a natural set point if you continue to eat that way. Because the Candida diet, first of all, it's not intended as a weight loss diet. And so if you're following it to lose weight, I've said this before, there are way easier ways to lose weight than on the anti-Candida program. So it's not intended to be a weight loss diet. It is a nutritionally sound, if it's followed properly, diet that provides your body with all the nutrients it needs to be healthy and thrive. And so if you continue to follow the program and you're eating properly, eventually what's going to happen is your body's just going to reach a set point. It's going to even out. You know, if you think of people who are on that calorie-restricted diet, I've seen people who, because there's a belief that if you eat fewer calories than your body actually needs, that you will live longer. So there are lots of people who intentionally eat fewer calories than their body needs. But even those people, eventually they reach a certain level and they might be a little bit slimmer than the rest of us, but they're not going to keep losing and losing and losing. Your body will eventually reach equilibrium and maintain where you are. So you shouldn't worry that you're going to get so skinny that you're going to look anorexic or look gaunt or skeletal or anything like that. And if that does start to happen, then you want to check with your doctor, obviously, to see if something else is going on. But the anti-Candida diet itself is nutritionally sound, and it should provide your body with what it needs. So those are really the three main reasons why I think people might lose weight. As I said, one is the shift from the highly processed, high fat, sugar, refined standard American diet to this new, very clean diet, and your body reacts. And along with that, which I didn't mention, I want to just throw in here, is the whole concept of inflammation, because that's a very inflammatory diet. And so when your body's inflamed, you're going to carry weight, you're going to carry water, you will have more inflammation and water weight. And so what happens to a lot of people is, as soon as they start losing that inflammation, they didn't even realize it was related to what they were eating and food sensitivities or allergies, they can drop pounds pretty quickly. In my case, that took some time. So it took me a while for my body to start losing its inflammation, about 3 to 5 months. So I didn't lose any weight, even though I was perfectly compliant on the diet at the beginning. And then boom, once I started losing weight, it started falling off without effort. So that inflammation, once the inflammation goes, the weight will go too. So the shift from processed to clean foods, also not knowing how to cook with these foods. So your diet may be too simple, too basic, too few meals or ingredients. And then the third thing is maybe it's not nutritionally sound. So you're eating foods that are part of the diet, but not enough of certain categories or certain foods to really feed your body what it needs. So I think once you address those three things, the weight loss really should abate. If it doesn't, as I said, there are certain foods you can eat to up your weight. As an example, high fat foods like avocado, increase those. And then you're going to increase your caloric intake, and hopefully that will help your weight level out as well. So I know a lot of people are concerned about weight loss, but I hope this helps to alleviate some of that concern. And I hope you found this information useful. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And more importantly, if you know somebody who could benefit from this, please let them know as well. If you're looking for guidelines and ways to get through the program in a way that's going to be helpful and that you can actually stick with it, I hope you check out my Candida Kickstart, because as I said, that's why I created that program, so that it could guide people through from beginning to end in terms of the food, in terms of the lifestyle, and everything else that you need in between. All right, thanks everybody, and I will talk to you next time. Bye.